Good afternoon, everybody. And the topic I have chosen to speak is language policy for India. Why should we speak about language? The first question is, why should we deal with this language anyway? Language is one feature that distinguishes man from the animal kingdom, and every generation adds this their own language repertoire to the existing amount of language. And this is applicable to any language in the world. And now coming to our country, that is India, it has about 720 languages and their dialects, with 22 fully developed languages with very highly developed structures and rich literatures. No other country has so many literatures, so many languages in it. Maybe a continent like Africa has many languages and dialects, but one single country having so many languages, and it needs to be seen into the past, why it and how it could happen. India actually has never been a single country. It has been small kingdoms ruled by different dynasties and different kings at different points of time. And each region developed with its own languages. For the past 1,000 years, many invaders had come, ruled India, all that history we know. And finally, the whole thing was consolidated into one nation by the British, under the British rule. And by the time British left our country, it was considered to be one single country with all these diversities in it. The diversities cannot go because they have been practiced by the people. So when the British left India in 1947, our educators and our policymakers, our political leaders tried to evolve some policy, particularly language policy for education. Actually, they encountered a problem fixing the national language because there were so many languages with fully developed literatures, and under one single central government, every state prides itself with its linguistic identity. And most of the states have taken their names after the languages. For example, Odisha and Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Tamil Nadu. Each state distinguishes itself with its own linguistic identity. So what to do? And after a lot of deliberations, Hindi had been fixed as the national language, but because the British education was carried on through English medium, English also was given the status of associate official language, and it has been made a compulsory language of study in the school and college levels, up to the tertiary level, that is the second year degree. And it has become the chief link language among the states, Indian states, since our independence. So now, many committees and commissions had been appointed. What is the three language formula? The first language is the local language or the vernacular language, the mother tongue of the majority of the people of the state. Second is Hindi, and third is English. Or sometimes second is English, third is Hindi. One is the national language and the other is the international language. All of you know that English had become international language from 1918, replacing French after the First World War, when the Allies became successful in, they were the victors in First World War. Now, following the three language formula, there was a suggestion also from all these committees and commissions that the primary level of education up to fifth class should be carried on through the mother tongue medium. This cannot be disputed with, because most of the students who joined schools at that time after independence, they came from the backward communities and remote areas, rural areas. This has been reiterated every decade. They have been, the suggestion has been supported by every commission, and even the National Framework of Language. Every committee supported this idea that the primary level of education should be through the mother tongue medium. But over years, we have found that if medium has been through the mother tongue, they are not so proficient in the other tongue. So now we have a very distinct divide between the group of students who are very successful in their educational and professional arenas, who come from very good background of study education, and rural area students who come from non-English medium background. So the social scientists argue that there should be English medium right from the beginning. So there is a suggestion, there is a very clear solution to this problem. The suggestion is that up to class 5, medium need not be fixed. 3 languages could be taught using the internationally recommended teaching, training, and testing methodologies of language. 3 languages could be taught, because this is based on the research finding that children, when they are in childhood, children are more agile to learn languages, any number of languages, and up to 6 languages they can really master in their childhood. Particularly spoken language is easily caught with exposure, and after 14 years of age, everybody becomes an adult learner, and the language learning capacity reduces gradually. So any number of languages could be taught in childhood. So up to primary level, these 3 languages could be taught, and maths, because it's a concept-oriented subject, it could be taught through English. And actually, another research finding is that it is not really logical to teach children the content-oriented subjects like science and social studies before they master the language. Because when they don't have language, they resort to memorization, memorizing the answers for the questions and just reproducing in the examination paper of content-oriented subjects. And this memorization takes a toll on the imagination of the child. Actually, creativity is impaired when more memorization is resorted to. Even our researchers have proved this. And we all know that Albert Einstein says, more innovations are wrought through imagination rather than through knowledge. Because knowledge is established. On the established knowledge, if we imagine beyond this, we can make some invention. So imagination is very important for children. And if imagination is important, we have to teach only languages. Because languages always improve their imagination, enhance their creativity, and we can test them and teach them in many more ways. Language is aimed at teaching skills, not the content. So you can use any content and teach language. So 3 languages have to be taught, along with mathematics in English, and up to 5th class. And once they get this strong language base, they can start studying social studies and science from class 6. Because with the help of the strong language base, they can master the heavy content-oriented subjects like science and social studies. And leave the choice of the medium, that is medium of instruction, to the students and their parents. Indian languages, so many Indian languages and dialects, about 720, would be safeguarded from extinction. Second, those who take up government jobs after leaving the school or after doing the UG degree, they can operate in the local language very effectively. And those who go for higher studies in the university or research or abroad for higher education, they have the language base of English, which also they study all through their school and also college, with the proficiency they had gained when they in the primary level, particularly in oral communication, where they become very comfortable, they can use that English proficiency to carry on their studies abroad. Teaching only 3 languages and concept-based mathematics through English, fixing the medium in 6th class, or some e-schools and techno skills and brilliant schools you have seen, they teach even environmental science, general knowledge, and you know, moral science, all kinds of subjects they introduce for class 1 children. And the class 1 child doesn't know Taj Mahal is a great monument, Shah Jahan loved his wife Mumtaz Mahal a lot, he doesn't understand Shah Jahan, he doesn't understand Taj Mahal, he doesn't understand Mumtaz Mahal. So this could be postponed to a later stage, where they understand language and they study subjects through. And then this memorization also would become less, and creativity would improve. And when we didn't get a Nobel prize in the past 70 years, except for the social work of Kailash Sachardhi, we might, our children might grow and get Nobel Prizes because of the enhancement of language ability. Man has a language box here, the psycholinguists say, and that box perceives the sounds and then understands the sounds, understands the words, and learns the words from the context, and then learns the language. Then that is how the child learns the mother tongue. The child, nobody teaches mother tongue to the child. So if in at primary level, these three languages are taught just like mother tongue, the child learns very easily. As we have seen in some of the interlinguistic marriages, the children speak the language of the mother, language of the father, language of the maid that works at the, language that is spoken on the street, and English in school. About four or five languages are mastered by them. And let me tell you one more example. There is a small island near England where many people from many ethnic groups had gone and settled there. About 350 different languages and their dialects are spoken there. Every child, by the time he is six or seven, masters about 75 languages and dialects without any teaching. They just interact with the children, with others, and learn languages. Language learning is so easy, and language learning gives a lot of advantages to the child, like confidence, like interaction, like oral communication. So if in India, which is a complex country, a complex society, and no state is ready to give up their own identity, which is found in their language, we have to have a national policy where three languages are respected equally, three languages are just are taught like languages, and the children, by the time they are 10 or 11, they acquire these language skills wonderfully, and then they base their higher education on the skills that they acquire in their primary level. And let us recollect the well-known American linguist Noam Chomsky, what he says about language. He says, it is the linguistic abilities of a human being that decide all other abilities. Linguistic abilities decide all other abilities of a human being. So remembering this, let us put it into practice in India and make our children very good at all the languages and become very socially and culturally sensitive because of their mother tongue proficiency, and educationally and professionally successful because of their proficiency in English. Thank you very much.